It was almost 20 years ago, a young Jose Heredia would cruise the streets of Tweedy Boulevard here in Southgate, California. And in his search to be cool, he would go inside a record store known as Yuri's Records to buy his records as a young DJ. And through that time, he got to learn and be able to grow here in Southgate, the place of his youth, the place where he found where to become a DJ. So let's go inside of Yuri's Records and explore what this magical place has in store.
A beat. And honey, you look fine, so I know it took time getting you fresh like fish, and I'ma hook mine, yeah. I wanna please ya, put you at ease, you freak, and I'ma skeeze ya, I'm with that. Boy, I wanna get that, take you home, enjoy you like a six-pack drinking. But let me start thinking if I really want you, and should I start winking? But nevertheless, I came here to move. Yo, baby, welcome to my groove.
So 20 years ago, we would come inside the store, and really, the store hasn't changed much. Just a couple of cosmetic stuff here and there. As we would walk in, I remember that the video games used to be on this side, and the counter over there would be right where it is. Today it's really just a shop to buy accessories, skate shop, a lot of tools for skateboards, t-shirts. You got a t-shirt wall right here, got a lot of cool t-shirts. I remember the t-shirts for Metallica used to be popular back then too. Here we have a wide assortment of CDs, although the CDs probably were different back then. Like we wouldn't have Stray Bullets. It would be more of the music of the time. We got the psychedelic posters back here. Taking a look at the black light posters. That's pretty cool. So this is Yuri's Records back in the day. This was our spot that we would go and find our stuff, our DJ gear, our DJ accessories to make us look cool. And thanks to Yuri's, it launched many a career. So as we stroll through the record shop known as Yuri's Records here in Southgate, we come across the inspiration behind Yuri's Records, Yuri's himself. How you doing, Yuri?
Doing good, and yourself?
I'm doing wonderful, just reminiscing about the past. And that's what I came here about, was to really talk to you or see if anybody would talk to us about the past. Okay. And I was just here earlier, we were recording and saying how things have kind of changed and some things have not.
Right.
You know, the posters, where they're at, as far as the shirts and stuff like that. So yeah. Tell me about your memories, the most fondest memories about this place and what it meant to you.
Oh, geez, this place, I've been here since I was 6 years old. So it's over 30 years now. It's deep in my heart because it's been part of my life for so long. But the best part's probably when I was in high school and the years thereafter, when the house scene was just starting to come up. And, you know, some of the guys here were really, really into it. They were really into what started on this side. Out on the west side, it was prominent, but out here, no one had heard of it. But Orlando, Herrick, Nelson, all those other guys, they were really important to the scene out here. And they started all right here, you know, making the flyers by hand, you know.
Yes, I remember.
Yeah, so that was a big thing. So that was probably the best time and the most important time to me.
Right, and all the guys I remember would have the mixer here, because I don't know if this is the original mixer.
No, this, you know, who knows? It may be. You never know around here. But no, this probably isn't it. But yeah, I remember they'd set up here. They'd set up in the back, wherever there was room. They'd set up the turntables and then, you know, speakers, wherever they could fit it in.
Yeah, I remember, like, if I would want to hear a record, they would put it on for me.
In a heartbeat. They would definitely do it. They'd open it up, you know, throw the vinyl on, and it was all good.
Exactly. And do you remember also the parties back then, the whole underground scene? Did you go into any of them?
I remember even when there was Twittier.
Twittier?
Yeah, when for I think it was two or three Wednesdays, I think it was, that they shut down Tweety to kind of cruise it. But the cops had enough of that after the first few weeks and they shut it down.
Yeah, I remember. I got a ticket one time, and it's something I want to forget. But it was a happening place. And with the Allen Theater next door,
right.
I mean, that was our destination spot back then. We'd come to Allen Theater, watch a movie, pick up a record or two, and then head on home.
Yeah, now you're going way back. Yeah, that was common out here. That, you know, I still run into a lot of people no matter where I'm at. that have that same, you know, their recollection of what they did in the past, you know, growing up here, whether they're from Huntington Park, Bell, it's still all familiar.
Right. And so right now, what is it that you do, and are you part of Yuri's? Or?
No, not really. I've never, you know, I left, probably when I was in college, but my sister still runs a store. You know, it's her store. She runs it day to day. She's here every day. A lot of you guys will probably remember her. If you've been in here, if you were in here 20 years ago, 30 years ago, she was still here.
As far as music, is there any tracks that you remember as being ultimate tracks back then? And then we'll talk about tracks that you hear now.
Jeez. Back then, in terms of what kind of music, house music or anything?
House music, anything, freestyle, old school disco.
Go back to the Sweet Sensation, the Cover Girls, then Mellow Man Ace, who we were just speaking of. Then I think the same time Mellow Man Ace came out, then Vanilla Ice. I know it was a one-hit wonder, but it was huge. Then sometime thereafter, you know, it turned more into some, you know, rock. Nirvana came on the scene, Pearl Jam. And but before them, you know, the house scene blew up, you know, at least locally. So you had, you know, a lot of the, you know, let's say like Chicago house. I know like Orlando, who used to, you know, work here for many, many years. He was really into that. And I think he still plays like really loungy house music. So, you know, this store's been through so many different, you know, scenes through the year. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's kind of like gone into a skater phase at one time.
Yeah. Well, now it's back to skater.
Back to skater phase, as we can see.
Yeah, all the skater stuff. Yeah, so, you know, go with whatever, you know, the time it calls for.
So that's our tour of Yuri's Records. Yuri, thank you very much for interviewing us. Any messages out there as far as our DJ community?
Hey, you know, keep going strong. And my sister wants me to make sure. 3801 Tweedy Boulevard Southgate. Come on down. Check it out.
Plug away. Thank you very much. Jose Heredia for the Crossfader Show. Fading out. Identity.
Yeah, the one that says you're not the father?
No, the one that says we think you're the father. You need to prove to us that you're not.
Nah, I got the letter that says you're not the father.
Oh, congratulations. Way to go.
Yeah. I don't know how to feel about it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how to feel about it. You know, 3 years, she just turned.
Kind of awkward.
Yeah, it is. So I said, let me go look for some Jim Morrison and see, you know what I mean? Well,